This is the one that you and I have been waiting for. The biggest update to Street Fighter V is going to be dropping on July 1st of next month. What's up, dudes? Max here, and I quickly wanted to talk about the update that's going to get me back into playing Street Fighter V. Some of the big changes that are going to be happening to the game that they're fixing that is freaking awesome, as well as the huge updated story mode. But first, take a look at this. What you're seeing is correct. A brand new stage. Apparently, it's the Karin Kanzuki Beach. And I know what you're looking at right now. It's the freaking monkey. Look at that freaking monkey sitting there riding a turtle. Pay no attention to the two rival school's characters to the left. Check out that freaking monkey! Seriously though, the two you see on the left as background characters are a couple from a game called Rival Schools or Project Justice, a couple of very old Capcom high school-based fighting games, and one is Tiffany and the other is Hinata. Now, I've made some videos in the past talking about future installments of Street Fighter V characters and things like that that would get me really excited. And the fact that SF5 is now confirming that it takes place in the same universe as Rival Schools has me pretty happy. We do know that Sakura made an appearance in the Rival Schools games to actually bring them together or to give them a little bit more popularity, because Rival Schools was a game that wasn't based on any fighting game at all. It was a completely new thing, and they were worried it wasn't going to be popular, so they let them use Sakura in the game because she was huge from the Street Fighter Alpha series. We know they exist around the same universe, but this is actual huge confirmation that Rival Schools characters live in tandem in the same world as Street Fighter characters, meaning that they wouldn't be crazy guests of some kind. The super far-fetched belief that a Rival Schools character would show up in Street Fighter V wasn't thought to have any credibility before when I was talking about it, but this almost solidifies it that Rival Schools characters can appear in this game. And man, if there was something else beyond Street Fighter V's first season of characters, if we saw Batsu, if we saw Kyosuke, if we saw any of the characters from that game, that would be absolutely awesome, because man, people have been missing out on the Rival Schools and Project Justice characters for quite some time, and I really think they would fit amazingly into a Street Fighter V title. Outside of that, the beach level looks fantastic. Karin's also getting a summer costume, which is hella lewd. Apparently not everybody else is getting costumes similar to this. And the other big part of the update is that we will be getting Ibuki and Balrog, also completely playable, on July 1st, which is a very nice addition considering we went a few months without a character update or any big update at all. It makes me realize that a lot of people seem to be having waning interest in Street Fighter V, including myself, over the past couple of months, simply due to the fact of there not being any updates. And this has happened to Killer Instinct, many other fighting games that require continual updates. You have to continuously update to keep people invested in this stuff. And it goes to show, once they start showing stuff, you get a beach level, you get a couple new characters, show off a couple future characters, everyone's excited to play Street Fighter V again, and I'm looking forward to checking out all the new content. That new content also includes the big story mode, like I was saying, but Yurien as well as Juri, who were shown in the trailers, which also look freaking fantastic. I'm shocked their faces aren't totally jacked up. If anything, the faces of a lot of the newer characters that have been revealed look pretty good. I mean, outside of Alex and a few others, they are looking very well and very traditional to their original characters. You might say Yurien has a outfit on that doesn't fit him at all, but actually it completely does, because he would start almost every single match in the Street Fighter 3 series with a business suit, and then it would blast off of his body. So I'm only hoping that later on, the suit comes off when he's in V-Trigger. However, Juri apparently did receive a small nerf to her design, depending on which perspective you had. She had a little bit more skin showing, and I'm pretty sure based on the feedback of what they'd been getting from some characters in SF5, they were probably reeling back on that. They covered her up a bit more, giving her a skin-tight black outfit underneath all of the clothes that she already has on, which kind of looks like a biker uniform. I do like this design a lot more. I like the eye patch. I think all that stuff is actually very neat. I'm curious to see how they play, but we did get a small hint that Aegis Reflector is going to be making an appearance in SF5, at least in some way, leaving me very curious how they're going to implement that and make it work. The other big part of this update is that matchmaking is going through a pretty big overhaul in terms of how the game matches you with other players, and depending on how your rank is, what kind of players you're going to be fighting against, which has been very desperately needed and apparently has been something that they've been working on for quite a while and is going to be available on July 1st. So, from July 1st, we're going to get two new characters. Of those two characters, you can bet that I will absolutely be playing as Balrog and probably not Ibuki. Once Balrog came out, he looks pretty interesting. And in all honesty, Balrog to me has always been the super traditional straight punch kind of like boring charge character that I've never really been a fan of. And from the little bit of gameplay we have seen, it does appear that they're trying to change things. So I don't know. I'm curious, is he going to be traditional charge like Guile, somewhat like Bison, where some things are charge moves and some things aren't? Either way, he's got a lot of fancy looking target combos now. A little bit more anticipating to play this character than Ibuki, only because Ibuki, from the little bit I played, was kind of weird. She wasn't like Ibuki from before, and I just think that Balrog looks a lot cooler to play. But yeah, those two characters, the cinematic story mode, where you will actually be able to play as Yurian and Juri. They're not in a finished state, but you will be able to mess around with them a little bit, which I'm going to spend as much time playing those characters and purposely dying on those story moments just to get as much playtime to mess around with them. Yeah, that's absolutely going to happen. No word of anything else beyond this, because this is the big update for SF5, and then we have those two characters that'll be coming down the line, most likely around August as well as September, and that's when the first season of Street Fighter V DLC kind of comes to an end. Beyond that, we don't know what is going to happen. Still missing an arcade versus, or like an arcade ladder of some kind. I'm pretty sure that's going to be in the works. And the big thing I'm curious about, who the hell is going to be the final boss of Street Fighter V story mode? Because there is one costume that is still missing amongst the roster that we haven't seen yet. And it's that battle-damaged Bison costume, which I'm assuming is going to make an appearance in the big story mode. Hopefully for a last boss. I don't know, I think Shin Bison as a final boss would be pretty cool. But either way, let me know what you guys think about all this stuff. Street Fighter V has been kind of missing from this channel. I haven't had a lot of motivation to play the game with all the other fighting games that I'm having a lot of fun with, but knowing that there's some new stuff on the way, as well as some big matchmaking changes taking place, has me pretty excited. And come Friday, you can anticipate seeing the full story mode playthrough on this channel starting up as soon as possible. I'll be continually playing the game on PC, mostly for the mods and all the incredible mods that have come out for this game and some stuff that will blow your mind. It's blown mine. And I'm not going to do that for the story mode because I want it to be traditional of the base story mode, not have all of a sudden Cammy as Tracer flying out of nowhere. That's all going to be coming up really soon. Thank you a ton for being patient, guys, on the Street Fighter front, and I'll be back with more as soon as possible. My name is Max, and I'll see you next time.